Hi people, today we are going to study binary search tree in data structure. So what is a binary search tree? Any tree which has only two or less than two children is called a binary tree. Like look at this example. In this, F is the root node and it has exactly two children. What are the children or child nodes? Are B and H. For F, it is B and H. Now B has two children, A and D, and H has two children, which is K. Now A, D and K are leaf node. Why? Because they don't have any children. Okay, and B and H are intermediate node. So that is what a binary tree is. Now what is a key? Let us learn some terms. Now key is the node value or the data, which is like in this case the root node has the key F and intermediate nodes have B and H. So those are the keys. Now left, whatever is on the left side of the node is called as the left child. Now when we implement binary tree using linked list, then we have pointers, left and right pointers. Okay, so now F has left child as B and A and D are left child of B. Okay, and F's right child is H and H's right child is K. Okay, so this is the left and right pointers. Now pointer to the parent node. When you want to come back during tracing, when you want to come back from the leaf node to the intermediate node or intermediate node to the root node, at that time this pointer helps, this pointer P helps in finding the path back. It has the key and the next. The next will give us the path back to the parent node. Okay, so now how to traverse a tree? So let us assume that we have this tree, and then this traversal will be done in three ways: in order, pre-order and post-order. What is in order traversal? In that the root node is traversed or written last and the left node is traversed first and the right node second. So in this in order traversal will be, first of all we will go to the leftmost side. So for F, the left side is B. Now B has a left child, so we will go to A. So first A will be traversed. Now does A have a left child? No. So A is the one who will get traversed first. Now back to the root node, which is B. For the subtree BAD, the root node is B. Okay. So when we are at B, we will write B. After that, we will traverse the right one, which is D. Then we will go back to the root node again, which is F. So we will now traverse F. Then we will go to the right side. So we will go to H, but we will not traverse H first. First we will check whether there is a left child of H or not. In this case there is no left child, so now we will traverse H. After that we will traverse the right child of H, which is K. Now the traversal is complete. This is in order traversal. So in program how you will do it? Recursively you are doing it. Now in this traverse will be called and X is the root node. Now if first what we will do, we will traverse the left of X. So in the left side we will see, here we are using arrays, so left side will be the left subtree, so we will traverse that. After traversing the left subtree, we will traverse the root node. So we are directly here printing the X, means X is the key of the root node. After that we will traverse the right subtree. Now for the first traverse left X, what will happen, the traverse function will be called again from the traverse function itself. That is why it is called recursion. So when it is recursively called, now the left subtree we will pass in X. So whatever is the root of the left subtree, that will become the value of X. So after that, again the left of the left subtree will be called. Now if there is no left of the left subtree, means it is a leaf node or maybe it doesn't just have left, at that time we will directly print the root itself. Now if it has a right node, then we will call the right subtree of the tree. Fine. So now when we are calling the right subtree of the root node, then again the immediate right child will be passed as X, and then after that the right subtree will be called. Now if it is a root node, then nothing will happen and directly the X will get printed. So traversal is completed. Now they will come back to, it will be returned back to the main root node, and after that, after traversing the main root node, it will go to the right subtree of the main root node. Okay, so see, this is an example. And how you have to remember, pre-order is root, left and right. First of all, at first you will write the root. which is at first F will be traversed, after that left subtree, after that right subtree. Okay, so in this the function will be what? Traversal x. In that we will first of all print the value of x, after that traverse left of x, and then traverse right of x. Okay, so I hope you understand this. In order, we just saw what is the function for that. Traverse x, traverse left of x, then print x, after that traverse right of x. Now same way for post order, what? Left, right and root. So that means first we will traverse left of x, then traverse right of x, after that we will print the x. The root comes in the last. So this is the basic of tree traversal. Now operations can be done like insert, search, delete, many things can be done. Now how to search? Let us see first search. Now for search we have the tree and the key. Means key is what? The element which you want to search, and x is the root node of the tree. So if x is equal to null, that means there is no root node, that means there is no tree itself. Okay, so at that time just return. Or if k is equal to key of x. Now the key of x is what? The root node value. And k is what? The element that you want to search. If both are equal, then just return the value of x, because at the root node only that element is present. Now if k is less than key of x, means if the value that you want to search is less than the root node, then you will search the left subtree of the tree. Because whenever a value is less, it gets inserted in the left side. If it is greater than, then it is inserted in the right side. Now assume that there is a value which is lesser than the root node but greater than the left child of the root node. At that time what will happen? It will come on the left side of the root node, means in the intermediate node. Then it will go to the right side of the intermediate node. Okay, I hope you understand now. So if it is not less than, then else part will be executed, and right of x and k. Means right of x will be called, that will be the root node now, the right subtree, and key, k is the whatever value you are trying to search. So that will be passed. Now tree search will be called again. This is also a recursive program. Okay, now another function that does the same is, this is not recursive, this is iterative. Why? Because we are using a loop over here. You can use any loop. So here we are using a while loop. Now while x is not equal to null and k is not equal to key of x, if k is less than key of x, then x is equal to left of x, means it is using an array and taking the left element and storing it as root, else x is equal to right of x. Now again the loop will execute. Now if x is null, then it will not go. If k is not equal to key, then only it will enter the loop, otherwise it will return the value of x. So which one do you think is more efficient, the recursive one or iterative one? Tell me in the comment section. Okay, now adds on an element. Now insertion, what is insertion? As I already told you, whenever you want to insert into a tree, you will check if the new value is lesser than f, then go to b. Now check if it is lesser than b, then insert it in a position, or go to a if there is a. Now check whether it is lesser than a or not. If it is lesser than a, then insert it on the left side of a as a left child of a. If it is greater than a, then insert it on the right child of a. Then come back to b. Now if you have another value that you want to insert, if it is, assume that it is greater than f, then go to h. Compare it with h. If it is lesser than h, then insert it as the left child of h. If it is greater than h, then compare it with k. Now if it is lesser than k, then insert it as a left child of k, or else insert it as the right child of k. Okay, so after doing this, this is how insertion is being done. Now this is an example. So for pre-order, what will happen? First the root, we know pre-order is root left right. So root is f, after that we'll go to the left side. So now the root is b, so I'm writing b. After that we'll go to the left again. Now there is no left child, only root is there, so a. After that we'll come back to b and check the right child, which is d. Then we'll come back to f and check the right child, which is h. H doesn't have any left, so we will directly write the h and then k. Now in order is what? Left, root and right. So first of all we'll go to the left of f, which is b, then left of b, which is a. So write a first, then write the root, which is b here, then write the right child, which is d here. Okay, where is c? Why did I write c? Okay, maybe I misunderstood. I inserted a value c. Okay, here it is. Here the c is. Now I hope you can see it. Okay, so what I'm doing, a, then b, then we are coming to d. Now D has a left child C. Okay, so I'm just writing the C first. After that, we'll write the center child, not the center child, the root node of this subtree, which is D. Now it doesn't have any right value, so just ignore it. Now come back to F. Now F has the right child, which is H. Now H doesn't have any left, so we will not trace the left part. We'll directly write the root node. After that, we'll write the right node. So F, H, K. This is how it is happening. Now post order. What is post order? Left, right, then root. So from F we will go to the left, which is B, then we will go to left, which is A. A doesn't have a left, A doesn't have a right, so we will directly write A. After that we'll come back to B, but we cannot write B first, we'll have to trace the right part first. So when we are going to write, this is the root node. Now, so let us trace the left side of the root node. So after A we are getting C. Now we are coming back to D and checking whether it has a right node or not. It doesn't, so we will now trace the D. So ACD is still now. Now we are coming back to the root node, which is B. A and left and right have already been traced, so now we will write B. So now let's come back to F, but we will not trace F first, we will go to the right child, because it is left, right, then root. We are doing post order. So when we are at H, now we will trace whether the left side of the H is there or not. It's not there, so move back to H and check the right side. So it is K. So let us write K here, then we will come back to the root node H, then we will come back to the main root node, which is F. So this is how it's done. Now for you, the assignment is create a tree from the following array: 2, 23, 1, 5, 7, 25, 8, 4, 15. And take 7 as the root node. Means what? You will have to write 7 first, then you will have to check 2. 2 is less than 7, so write 2 here, then 23. 23 is greater than 7, so write 23 on the right side of the 7, then 1. 1 is less than 7, 1 is also less than 2. So you will write 1 on the left side of 2, then 5. 5 is less than 7, but 5 is greater than 2. So 5 will be right node of 2. Okay, right child of 2, and so on. So try it. I hope you understand. Thanks for watching.